My hair is messy, man, but I'm about to go pick up John right now. We're about to go to his house, pick him up. He has a really good good surprise to tell you guys and tell me. He finally got his copy ID of his driver's license, which he's needed to start his life, man. I'll be speaking about John more, man, and how we found him, how I found him at the hospital at West Oaks. And yeah, guys, he's been a really great friend of me and a friend of mine's, and we're gonna progress together as a team because that's what God has ordained us to do, to be a team. All of us, we have to work in unison, in unity as a team together. Two are better than one, guys. It's just how it is. Personally don't agree with it, but we're getting John some cigarettes. I'm not buying them for him. He made this money from us working in the curbside business, but I tell him to stop, to quit it, you know, especially following God. It's not like it's bad to smoke cigarettes nor drink alcohol. The Bible even doesn't talk about how drinking till you get drunk is a bad thing, but drinking alcohol in general isn't bad. But when you get drunk, that's when it becomes an issue. Cigarettes, the Bible doesn't mention, but it's just the vice that it gets you. But he says for him, it does him good. So, you know, it is what it is. But I really would want him to stop. But hey, I can't control him, and that's his life, you know. So, that's life. Just arrived to John's place. I'm about to pick him up right now. We're about to go get cigarettes, as they said, and he has a surprise to show you guys, which I'm really excited for. So we'll see when he comes out right now. We'll see when he comes out, because he takes a while. Back then he would come out quickly. Now he takes a long ass time. There he is.
Brother,
what's up? Check, I got this, the vlog.
Check this out. You got the vlog
going? I got the vlog going.
Check it out.
All right, guys, look at what he's got.
From 2019, I lost it last year.
Man, point at when looking at the vlog, John,
copy of my ID
based on this camera right here, these right okay. Here, when so you can look at them.
So this is my ID,
yeah.
And 2019, I lost my apartment, and so last year I lost my ID, mm-hmm. And for 3 years I've been in and out of bad group homes and homelessness, and so now finally I'm going to get my ID. I'm going to start a GoFundMe campaign for about $20,000 so I can start my business It's called BLB. If anybody else wants to get involved, Oz Konar is the guy to look up on YouTube. Beautiful business. He's got it all mapped out. I'm looking forward to getting started in that. Right now, me and David have started a little business painting the numbers of the homes on the curbs, and that's really helping me. It's providing me a little bit of necessities for now.
For cigarettes.
Yeah. David's keeping me honest.
Yeah.
For cigarettes.
Yeah.
And then, but it's such a great blessing that my old doctor had a copy of my ID, and my new doctor, Dr. Son Duong out in Rosenberg, XSL, really good doctor. Mm-hmm. They told me they had a copy of my ID originally, but when I went out there for my doctor's appointment, they didn't have a copy of it. So I was like, oh man. So then I got home, I called another clinic that I went to and another doctor that I went to, my old primary care physician, Dr. Julio Molina out in Rosenberg. And sure enough, they had a copy of it. So
you called a place first, and then they told you, we have a copy of it.
Yeah. And
so you thought of somebody to call.
Yeah. Right. My old primary care physician, Dr. Julio.
That's
Molina.
Good. Good thing you remembered, bro. Yeah. That's a blessing right there. Memory. Yeah. God gives us that.
Right. Right.
All right.
Memory, intellect, and will. Your will is
willpower.
Right here.
Willpower. Yeah. Yep. In the heart. Where again?
Yep. Your will is right here. It's been revealed to me in prayer and spiritual experiences that your will is deep inside the center of your chest.
Center of your chest. Yep. Willpower.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Sadly, we're going to go get cigarettes, man. I told him to stop, but he just does not want to stop, man. What do you got to say about that?
I wish I could, but it's like a medicine for me right now, smoking. Oh, God. Even Dr. Phil said that to one of his people he was counseling one day. He said, you're self-medicating with nicotine.
Like, exactly, self-medicating with nicotine.
Who is he to tell this lady that she can't self-medicate with nicotine? I mean, so many people are non-smokers, and they're like, you can't smoke. But I mean, I respect your opinion.
Yeah.
That's for you. For me, I'm a smoker. But I do want to vape. After I get on my feet well enough and can afford a good vape, the filament won't go out on me, you know, such a short time like the one I got.
Yeah.
But I do want to fix that one when I have enough money. It's more healthier cigarettes, so don't worry, all you reformed smokers out there, and you people who don't want me to get cancer, I'm gonna start vaping after I get on my feet enough and I can afford it. So don't worry.
Awesome, guys. So we're gonna go to the corner store and then come back, and yeah, let's do it.
And then tell a story about how I became homeless.
Yeah.
Lost my apartment, became homeless, got in trouble with the law many times. By the way, I also called Fort Bend County about those four charges, and I didn't talk to the attorney, but I left a message on his voicemail.
Uh-huh.
And he's going to get back to me. So I told him to go ahead and send me a copy of all the testimony against me of those charges so I can refute it, you know, because the only thing I can't refute is stealing a banana at Walmart. I did that, and I'm guilty, but all the other ones is just bullshit charges where the cops just screw with you, man. So much bullcrap.
This side's gonna be, I feel, our most
prominent
one.
Well, I wanted to go in a distant subdivision, just down about not even half a mile down this way on Derry Ashford, I think it is.
Yeah.
Because I wanted to save this for me so I can work, get a few jobs during the week, you know, to supplement my income a little bit.
Yeah.
But, you know, if we get four jobs and complete it by Sunday every weekend, that's $40 for both of us. That's $40 to you, $40 to me. That's a lot of money.
It is.
For a 2 days work, for a simple little job like that. It's good money.
And then
I know it's this way, dude.
Oh, we're going to turn to the left?
Yeah, because they don't have those cigarettes down there.
Oh, okay.
Well, I really wasn't doing anything criminal. But you have a tendency, though, when you are homeless, to wear out your welcome in different places, and that's where they criminal trespass you. When you kind of make a nuisance of yourself, and you've been there, going there too long to certain locations. So it's kind of sad, but I mean, all I was doing was going to church and receiving grace by going to the services there, but they criminal trespass me. Well, another thing I did wrong.
From your left or right?
The Sunny's.
Oh, Sunny's. Okay.
What I did wrong, though, at the church, and I admit this, I did wrong, but it wasn't criminal. But they told me to stop asking for money, or don't ask for money in the church. So
yeah.
I started doing that because I was desperate, and I was working outside the church, parking cars, and cleaning up trash around the church for Christmas time. And then that's what started my little entrepreneurial enterprise down there of doing that and getting tips for that work. But then when I started going inside the church, that's when they started getting irritated with me, and they told me, several guys warned me, but I don't know why, I just couldn't correct myself.
Yeah.
It's because I was homeless and I wasn't thinking completely clear. I was thinking pretty clearly, But I just wasn't thinking completely clearly enough to say, hey, you know, this is the church. Do what they're telling you about not asking for money inside the church. And I just kept doing it, you know, every now and then. And
he disobeyed.
Yeah, I disobeyed. Right. Yep. Disobedience.
Disobedience is what is the cause of sin, man. It's what caught.
Yep.
Disobedience is the cause of sin or is sin?
Disobedience is sin, basically.
Exactly.
Disobedience. When you know you're doing the wrong thing and you do it anyway.
And do it anyway.
And that's what I was doing. Yeah. So I just didn't think, because I thought the people were there really liked me. And I know the priest did. I was really good friends with the priest of the parish. But things happen.
Yeah.
And getting this new business started, me and you, is helping me to be able to forgive people easier. Because there's so much positivity now building in our lives, and my life in particular, that I'm able to forgive more easily now. And I found a technique to, when I start to get upset and angry about situations, I pray. I turn to the rosary and I pray. I pray the decade of the Holy Spirit, the sin of the Holy Spirit of Pentecost.
Yeah.
And when I do that, it calms me down. I'm able to forgive the people or the situation. And things work out a lot better.
Awesome, Don. Get your cigarettes. Feel bad, man. Right now I'm like at Sunny's with John, and there's this homeless guy, and he doesn't even have like a shoe. He has like one shoe on, but he doesn't have both pairs of shoes. It's crazy. The fuck? And he's screaming now. Look. Can you see? He's just staring at the mirror. See, he has no shoe on. See, he has just one pair of shoes, another one now. Feel bad for the man. You back, bro?
Oh, I still cannot believe that ID came. I was so happy when I didn't know what it was.
Yeah.
I knew it was something from the doctor's office, but I didn't snap until I pulled it out of there. I was thinking, what is this?
Yeah.
And I thought, wait a minute. When I saw it open, I thought, this is it, but why is it so big and dark? I
mean, yeah.
They just enlarged it. So I was like, oh, cool. That's even better, you know? A little bitty. They may not have been able to see my face very clear, but now it's clear. ID's a done deal. And Operation ID downtown is going to give me $11 to pay for the ID at the Department of Motor Vehicles of Texas.
That's lit, bro.
Department of Motor Vehicles.
That's good.
But everything's starting to come together. It's been slow since I moved into this group home. It's been slow coming, but things are starting to fall into place. And now I'm gonna apply for food stamps, and hopefully by December, if I lay my groundwork right and cover my bases with Social Security, I should be able to get my first check coming in December. But it's a whole different ballgame now than it was, you know, 13, 14 years ago when I first got on those disability income, SSI, and food stamps. Because then I was retired. I didn't think about working. But it always sucked not having any money on me and people having to do things for me. I just kind of took it for granted. It was, you know, sad to say, I was using people.
Yeah, it is what it is. Call it like it is, bro.
Yeah, I was using people, honestly. And so people were real nice to provide for me that way.
Yeah.
But I mean, there comes a time when, and that's this whole journey of being homeless, losing my apartment in 2019, these last 3 years have been a journey of learning the lesson that just came upon me about the last several weeks, is that God allowed all this to happen. All these negative things, these trials and tribulations, suffering, it was not easy. Not easy at all, but it's teach me, John, you've got to work. You got to stand up, be a man, and work, you know, for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
And I don't want to retire ever. I don't want to retire.
That's what
I always want to be doing something.
Right, doing something. That's what I talked about today, guys. I was talking about applying the pressure. You got to do the work. You got to run to it. You got to run it. You got to run the ball. You got to put in the work, because if not, like, you're not going to be able to enjoy the fruits of your labor. You're not going to produce anything. It's what I talked about today about the uncooked spaghetti. If you don't apply pressure, if you don't apply heat, if you don't apply friction, you're going to be eating hard spaghetti, because it's not going to be soft. It's not going to be useful for its intended purpose, which is to eat. Same thing with work. It's to eat. It's to enjoy, you know, your labor from your labor. Enjoy the fruits of your labor from work. You buy things for yourself. Same thing when you work out. And so you enjoy how you look, you feel good about yourself. But if you're all fat or you're skinny or you don't have muscles or whatever the case might be, and you see yourself every day in a mirror, you're gonna be upset. But if you work and you put into work, you're gonna be happy seeing that mirror. You're gonna love it. Same thing with when you put into work, you're gonna love that you're putting into work, because you actually get to see the fruits of your labor manifest in reality, you know. And so that's what I was talking about today, John, literally.
Yeah, you know, and it's scriptural too, as far as me retiring off the government dole, and that means receiving government benefits for 10 years, not doing anything. That was wrong with me. There was something that happened. I'm not going to share that. It's kind of personal. Something happened in my life that precipitated that, you know, retiring and receiving those government benefits. But life gets easy like that. And it's not until God wakes you up, like losing my apartment. These last 3 years of being homeless in bad group homes, I was getting killed in two of them. This is all woken me up. Big time wake up call. And St. Paul says, he who does not work does not eat. He's not supposed to eat. And so, you know, I've been eating and drinking off the government all this time. And, you know, I'm a constitutional conservative, and I see the value of work. I mean, when I was young, I'd bust my butt framing houses, doing paint and remodeling. I had a couple of businesses, paint and remodeling, landscaping. And never was a huge success at it, but I plan on becoming a huge success with the BLB, the Business Lending Blueprint of Alex Konar. And I can't suggest it highly enough to anybody else out there that wants to make a good living and possibly build up a business in about 5 years and sell it for several million dollars. Go for it. Alex Konar is a great guy. He's a reputable guy in the industry. He knows what he's talking about. He's done his homework. He laid all this out for us. And it's only, what is it, $2,167 total to get into his package and learn all the stuff he knows and do marketing on social media. And if you want to finance it, I think it's eight something, but it turns out to be about $2,500 if you finance it over three payments. I'm gonna finance it. It'll be a little bit more expensive, but that'll give me more money to work with to bide my time until about 2 weeks to 30 days. I'll be making some commissions off the business of awesome. Business Lending Blueprint.
Awesome. So that's the plan, guys, for John. For me, it's a little bit different. For me, it's selling my course and then doing one-on-one coaching sessions with you guys. I'm really excited for that day to happen, for that day to come, for that time to come, you know. But yeah, we're about to go drop John off, and then I'll talk to you guys when I get home. So I just got home and just wanted to finish on a good note, on the last note. So yeah, me and John, man, we make a good team, man. We're going to be working. We're going to be helping each other out, man. Just strengthening our bond, our relationship, our friendship, man, and see where it takes us, man. It'll take us far, because that's what the Bible talks about. Together, you can go far. Like, if you want to go fast, go by yourself. But if you want to go far, then you got to go in twos. You got to have a team around you. But anyways, yeah, life is good. God is good. You have a blessed one. Live a laugh. Peace.